For more on the national budget, we have with us Senate President Pro Tempore Ralph Recto. Welcome to Hot Copy, Senator. It's nice to have you back.
Hi, Karen. Thank you for having me. Good morning.
All right. Let's make the ordinary Filipino understand what this all means. Extending the 2020 budget, extending Bayanihan 2 for 6 more months. Is this good for the Filipino people? And what does this mean to the economy?
Yes, I think it's good for the Filipino people. In fact, I've been talking about this a month or 2 months ago, no, during the budget deliberations in the Senate. We know that our spending is still very low. And in effect, what it means is that next year you have roughly 4.7 trillion and then you add the Bayanihan 2 extension and the JA 2020 extension, that's another 150 billion. So roughly next year, government can spend 4.85 trillion, more or less.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So but additional then spending is good.
All right. But the fact that we need to extend both, it means that the funds coming from the 2020 budget and Bayanihan 2 were frankly unspent this year. And then we have a new budget coming up for 2021.
That is correct. So unfortunately, hindi nagastos this year. And that's why you had the economy contract by roughly 10%.
Mm-hmm. But where will we get the money? We're talking about the 2020 unspent budget, Bayanihan 2, and then 2021, which would have to be borrowed, a bulk of it.
Yes. Well, frankly speaking, 2020, the revenues are already here with us. The money is already with us. The borrowing is already with us. In fact, you have more than what? A trillion or more pesos in cash. So there is money available. That's not a problem.
Okay.
Yes.
No, go ahead, Senator.
Yeah, so money's not a problem. The money's available. It's with the Treasury. So they already borrowed the money, assuming that they were to spend the budget in 2020, which they were not able to. Mm. So nandiyan yung appropriations, might as well extend it.
But
the money's available.
What are the implications of having to extend an old budget to the next year and even Bayanihan 2 to the next year? It doesn't sound good to the ordinary citizen.
What would we rather have? No extension and the government will spend less in 2021? It will be more difficult to recover, for the economy to recover if we spend less. Mm. Government is 25% roughly of the total economy. The private sector will not be making those investments which we need, right? Mm. And it is incumbent upon the government, who has the balance sheet, to do the spending.
Okay. All right. Moving now to the 2021 budget, what concerns you about next year's budget the most?
Well, we're only spending 1% of the health budget, number one, for health infrastructure. No, Nakita natin, nagkaroon ng stress test yung health infrastructure natin at nakita natin na kulang. Mm. So, I don't mind spending 700 billion with DPWH, but a big portion of that should have been used to spend for health. Mm-hmm. Improve our health capacity to begin with, di ba? Mm-hmm. Okay. Of course, number two, the most important thing in the budget this year or next year is how do we address the pandemic? Okay, so is the 72 billion or the 82 billion available next year for vaccines enough to inoculate 60-70% of the Philippine population? Baka kulang pa yon, ano? Because you'll have to make advance payments for the next 2 years. So maybe what you probably will be needing is more than 150 billion, plus the logistics, the training, so on and so forth.
Yeah. Okay. Now, you did say that we would need more, like something like 100 to 150 billion. I wanted to ask you about the budget for COVID vaccines, the fact that 2.5 billion is assigned to the DOH and you have 70 billion in unprogrammed funds. And Senator Drilon says unprogrammed funds means funds that are unsure. Would you agree with that? Because you do have a big bulk going to DPWH that's essentially programmed, and then 70 billion of unprogrammed funds. What does this exactly mean to the ordinary Filipino if it is unprogrammed?
Ang ibig sabihin lang naman niya kung ang program uutangin. In simple terms, no? That means we will be borrowing the money for those vaccines. Now, would it be better if it were in program? Of course, because it's just a matter of priority. We're saying that, okay, we have the money already available and let's buy those vaccines. Hindi na kailangan utangin yan. It's a matter of priority. Diba? And there's available cash anyway, so might as well put it in the program. But you know, I understand what Senator Angara did. Mm. In fact, I was the one who recommended in the committee report to begin with, in the Senate version, to include it in UN-program. No?
Okay, why is that?
Yes, because it's easier. It's easier to, you know, you cannot increase the budget. You'll have to make cuts.
Mm.
What is listed in UN-program, let's say there were infrastructure projects, foreign assistance projects listed there, many of them were for the DOTR, which we know that they have difficulty in spending anyway.
Mm-mm.
So might as well put it for the vaccines.
Mm.
So that's what we did in the Senate, which eventually found its way in the bicameral conference committee report. Now, for sure, there will be funds available for the vaccines. That's not an issue.
Mm-mm.
The issue is the appropriations cover. How much are we willing to spend?
Mm.
Right? So right now, you have 72 billion, 70 in the program, another 2.5 in the program, and another 10 billion in Bayanihan too.
Mm.
And that's why you want to extend Bayanihan too. So it's now about 82 billion.
Okay. Roughly. Now, the ADB came out with a report that said that the Philippines' COVID-19 war chest is very small compared to our neighboring countries, compared to Malaysia and Thailand. Is there anything that the Philippines should do, Senator Arecto? So you're saying technically there's 82, the 70 can surely be borrowed. So we don't have to depend the 70 on the excess revenues coming from targeted tax collection. It doesn't have to fall on that definition, right?
Nope.
No. Okay.
It's borrowing.
It's borrowing.
It's borrowing, yes.
Okay. So a full 82 with the ADB report saying we have a small budget, what should the country do for next year?
When the ADB says that our war chest is small, it talks about fiscal stimulus.
Mm.
And precisely why I agreed to extend the Bayanihan 2 and the budget. In fact, I just filed the bill of Bayanihan 3.
Mm.
There's a version in the House also for Bayanihan
3. Yes, yes.
Right? Okay. Mm. So
we'll talk about Bayanihan 3 later in detail, but go on.
Okay. Well, like I said, you need additional stimulus to spend for the economy, you know? One against the, more so now that you have light at the end of the tunnel, so to speak, you have the vaccine. You're going to make advance payments for that. No? At the same time, you want to help families cope up with the situation. So many families have lost their jobs, right? Mm. So many people have lost their jobs. So. Then you had the three typhoons last year.
Mm.
Okay? We were hit in the gut.
Mm.
Because that's our rice granary. That's where our vegetables are coming from, so on and so forth. No? So you will need to make this investment. So you need to have additional stimulus, like I said.
Okay. And other than Bayanihan 3, I wanted to ask you, at a forum that I moderated, businessman Ricky Razon said that government should spend something like 20% of GDP. Right now we're spending, is it 5%? Senator Sunny said a target of 10% would be more apt. How much should we spend?
Our deficit today is about 10% of GDP. Because our revenues fell off the roof, right? So to speak, no? So bumagsak yung revenue natin, then our borrowings increase.
Mm.
Our spending is more or less the same, no?
Mm.
So the deficit is roughly 10%. We probably can afford another 2-3%.
Mm.
1% roughly is about 150 to 200 billion.
Mm.
Okay? So maybe another 400 billion. In additional spending.
Okay. So do you believe that the executive shouldn't be as conservative as they are today?
Yes. I've said that since last year, no?
Mm.
Remember, in the beginning of the pandemic, I think second quarter, they said that the economy will drop by only about 2%.
Mm.
And I said it's going to be worse than that. And then on July, when they made the budget, it was about, they were saying 5 to 6%.
Mm.
The third quarter numbers came out and the first three quarters were negative 10, roughly. we'll end up this year negative 9, negative 10. Okay. What is that amount? That's roughly 1.95 trillion pesos drop in GDP.
Yeah, of negative growth.
Now, in terms of lost opportunity, we should have grown another 1,950. So we lost 3.9 trillion this year because of the pandemic. In terms of productivity. So why not spend 150 billion more for the vaccines, train our health workers, pay them properly, so on and so forth. We cannot afford this another 3 to 5 years. Siguro what we should do is in 2 years, we're able to vaccinate 70 million, 80 million Filipinos. Kung pwede, lahat. Provide for all.
The numbers are quite clear when you're explaining it. In other words, spend now, and then you'll see the gains later on. If you don't spend now, we're talking about more losses.
That's right. Rather than have economic scarring. Meaning to say, you know, when businesses close, it's harder to reopen.
Okay. So, if we add another 3% spending to GDP, how much money should the government pour in for 2021? You have a 4.5 trillion peso budget, an extension of Bayanihan 2, which is roughly, is it 150 billion? Something like that?
The budget next year, including unprogrammed, is roughly 4,670.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. And you believe...
And Bayanihan 2 and the GAA, I was told, is roughly 150. So 4,670 plus roughly 150 billion, so mga 4.8 plus.
Okay. And do you believe that is enough in stimulus already?
I filed a Bayanihan 3 of roughly another 400 billion.
Okay. There's a version in the House, I think that's 305 billion. Okay. Yeah. And the 400 billion for Bayanihan 3, will include what, Senator?
First and foremost, yung kulang sa vaccines.
Okay.
Okay. Remember, you will be paying in advance these vaccines. No? Di ba rin ang sumobra pa yung bayad natin? And provide for 100% of the population without even mandating it. But it's available. Kung gusto nila, pwede sila magpabakuna. That's how it should work. Hindi yung 60% lang, 70% lang, nagtitipid tayo. Let's get the best vaccine available, the most effective, the safest. Let's not say na ito, mas mura to, mas maano to, mababay effectiveness ito, safety nito, pero mas mura to, ito kunin natin. I think let's give the people the best available in the market. Magkano lang naman yan? It's not, like I said, you lost 3.9 trillion. Let's spend 150 billion. What is 150 to 3.9, right?
Okay. Now, you did say also that you were disappointed. I mean, not in these words, but you said there was no plan. Hula-hula lang itong COVID purchase, distribution. There's a lack of a comprehensive, so to speak, plan that was presented. I'm curious, what would you want to see government have? What aren't you satisfied with?
You know, last night we were able to pass a resolution. No, there was a privileged speech done by Senator Pangilinan based on our interpolations the previous weeks. Okay. So there will be a committee of the whole in the Senate. Okay. It's possible that during the holidays we might have sessions.
Okay.
Including when we come back to discuss with the executive the game plan. Will they be ready or ready to inform the Senate or Congress that this is our plan? Okay, halimbawa. Okay, so which vaccines are we purchasing? Why are we purchasing them? What will be the quantity? When will be the delivery? What will be the manner in distributing this nationwide? Do we start in Metro Manila, Region 4, Region 3, where the economy is 70%? Where most of the cases are in? The metropolis, Metro Manila, Region 4. Pwede ba yung tawag dito yung Pfizer dito sa Metro Manila? Ah, yung negative 80 degrees, kaya ba natin kahit sa Metro Manila lang yan? Do we start with our health workers? The vulnerable population, 60 and above. So on and so forth. So, yeah, how are we going to do it? Are we going to use the local government units? Do we train our personnel? Because we've never done this before. Right? We've never inoculated 70 million people twice. Remember, some of these vaccines, the second dose is 3 weeks apart, 4 weeks apart.
Actually, what's interesting, Senator Ralph, is I interviewed Secretary Galvez, I think just a few days ago, and he answered on Head Start these very questions you're asking. But what's quite shocking is if the senators don't know it, ang tanong lang ng tao, di ba kayo nag-uusap lahat?
Precisely, that's why I asked Senator Rangara during the BICAM. Yeah, dahil tumagal yung BICAM eh. So I was thinking, bakit tumagal? Siguro the IATF or Secretary Galvez was talking to the chairman, both chair of the House of the Senate in the BICAM panel to ensure that there's budget cover. Unfortunately, there was none. So hindi nag-uusap. And that's why we have this committee of the whole so that we are informed of the government plan so that we know if need be, to pass a supplemental budget, to put it in Bayanihan 3, chances are we will have another supplemental budget. It may be called Bayanihan 3, it may be called something else.
Based on essentially what I'm hearing from you, do you believe that the government acted quite late when it comes to vaccine purchase? I mean, now we're hearing Indonesia, for example, has already ordered 1.2 million or a huge number of doses of Sinovac that was the first available to them. Pfizer's going to the Western countries first. But are we acting as a country quite late?
Hindi naman siguro. Mabuti rin na pinag-aaralan natin na mabuti. But let's plan it already. And let's do it immediately. There is money available, right? Let's get everyone on board, including the private sector. I think government is trying its best, but I think we have to move faster.
Okay. Now, another question. When it comes to the DP...
Incidentally, sorry.
Go ahead.
But I heard also them say that 3 to 5 years, that's too long.
Yeah, that's too long.
I don't think it should take 5 years. I think our plan should be 2 years.
For the whole country.
I think it will be hard to survive 3 to 5 years.
Okay. Senator, I have a personal question for you.
Yes.
Secretary Galvez said the first vaccine to be rolled out in the Philippines will most likely be from China because Pfizer had informed him that we would get it on the third to fourth quarter of 2021. And that's, some say it's quite late. Would you be willing to be inoculated with a vaccine coming from China?
You know, what do the doctors say? What does our FDA say? What do the scientists say? I think we have a group there studying that, right? If they tell us it's good for us, it's effective, it's safe, and we see that other countries are using it, why not?
Okay. All right. Now, speaking of the budget, going back to that, Senator Ping Lacson has criticized the increase of the DPWH budget, which is quite interesting considering the utilization of DPWH is low. Some critics have called the 2021 budget an election budget, frankly, not a COVID response budget. So do you believe the president should veto some items in the budget when it comes to DPWH?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
Like I said, Karen, no, I would have preferred that we spend more on our health infrastructure. I think we should be spending more on our classrooms also. Okay, so that we have less kids in a classroom. Social distancing, right? Okay. And now's the time to do it. Kasi walang bata sa eskwelahan. Okay? So, I would prefer that we spend more on health. No? Education, for example, no? Rather than other projects. Nevertheless, all of that will be part of a stimulus. All of that will be part of a rebound. All of that will be part of a recovery plan. of some sort. But the most important really is to address the pandemic.
Yeah. But what does this budget say, given in the time of COVID, where vaccination is most important, health is primordial to the growth of the economy, you have DOH at number three.
Yeah. You know, Karen, let's make it simple. Matatapos na yung taon, hindi pa natin binabayaran yung mga health workers natin. Mm. Ha? Ano, hinihintay ba natin? Mag-caroling ba sila sa atin?
Mm.
Matatapos na yung taon, yung pinangako natin under Bayanihan 1, Bayanihan 2, na mga allowances sila, hazard pay nila, both public and private, ibigay natin.
Mm.
Pag natin ititipid, we will need them next year also to help inoculate when we roll out the vaccine, so on and so forth. You will still have cases. Palagay ko, dadami pa yan dahil pagkatapos ng Pasko, syempre, yung social distancing, mababawasan ng quality during Christmas.
Mm.
And it's possible that you have more cases come January.
Mm.
Right? So, like I said, yung simple muna, unahin natin kaagad, bayaran natin yung mga health workers natin.
Mm-hmm.
All our frontliners who we call heroes, rightfully so.
Mm.
Give them, pay them their due.
Mm.
Yun ang unahin natin. Mm. And make sure that in the budget next year, there's adequate resources to do all of that.
So this is an executive implementation problem. You said there's the money. So are you calling on the DBM to fast track releases? Who is accountable for these delays?
You know, I don't know, but the DBM should release the money and the DOH should pay our frontliners. You know, I read an article 3 weeks ago, PGH. Yung allowance sila, hindi nababayaran, 39 million lang.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Diba? Yeah, yeah. Okay, now, very quickly, in terms of raising funds, you said that the 70 billion of unprogrammed funds for COVID vaccines is technically all loans, right? I want to ask you this. Senator Drilon said, is asking, how can the government raise funds? Now, that's essentially what he's asking. He says, the government must do another cash sweep in order to raise the funds to implement these programs in the Bayanihan 2 and the continuation of the 2020 budget. And he's saying, why didn't we realign, or all of you realign, idle funds?
Yeah, I support that. I think the executive, Secretary Dominguez did that for a part of Bayanihan 2. What he missed out was PICT.
Yeah.
So there's another 30 billion there lying around, right? And I support that too. We can use that money.
So can that still be corrected?
For contact tracing.
Yeah.
You need all of this.
Yeah.
Right? You still have to do all of that. There will be therapeutics yet. You know, eventually, if you have a vaccine, there's going to be a cure too.
Mm. Now, ang tanong ko nito, can that still be done? So the budget's been passed. Oh, how could you then realign the parked 33 billion, the 33 billion parked funds in PITC? How could that still be used, Senator?
Yeah, all it needs is a signature of the president.
Mm.
Huh? So in 33 billion, ibalik sa treasury, and we can spend it on something else.
Mm. Okay.
For those that are not obligated.
Mm.
That's perfectly legal to do.
Mm-mm-mm. Okay.
It's so, another priority, right?
Yeah. Hindi pa pala hopeless yon. Now, very quickly, the 19 billion pesos that several lawmakers have actually said, I mean, it was practically untouched, that was assigned to the NTFL-CAC for anti-insurgency. How do you feel about that?
To me, that's fine. Huh? That's the program of the executive, and they wanted that intact.
Okay.
You know, the compromise to eh. Kasama yan sa usapan with the executive. Okay? We were able to find the funds or to cut the appropriations on other departments to have that 82 billion. We could have done more, no doubt about that, right? Okay? But that was a request of the executive. So nag-request sila. So pwede mo naman pagbigyan din yun. yung 19 billion for their anti-insurgency program. Mm. So that's okay with me. That's fine with me.
Okay. Would you agree with Senator Lacson when he said that this budget essentially is a budget that was actually made to accommodate congressmen and lawmakers and senators and in terms of their pet projects?
And the executive.
Okay.
Tripartite. House, Senate, and the executive. Every year, that's what the budget is. That's what lawmaking is all about. Mm. It's about compromises, the art of the compromise, and passing it on time to have a budget. Remember, the budget starts with the executive through the NEP. We started with a vaccine budget of 2.5 billion. We're now as high as 82 billion. We had to make cuts somewhere, right? Okay, now, for 2020, the economy shrank by 10%.
Yeah.
1.9 trillion.
Mm.
Okay. Many projects were not undertaken in the districts.
Yeah.
Millions of people have lost their jobs.
Mm.
Okay. It is only natural for lawmakers, legislators, Congress, and the Senate, now, what would be the best way to create jobs? Okay, so what did we increase? Yes, the DPWH budget was increased. Of course, if I had my way, I'd put more of those resources in building hospitals.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, now, in addition to that, there is also a lot of resources added to DOLE,
yeah,
to DSWD, to help people who lost their jobs, to create temporary jobs in the process,
okay,
to train our workers.
Yeah.
And to help people in crisis.
Moving on to the bigger picture, the Philippines was one of the region's most promising economies, and yet the IMF actually came out with a statement just recently saying that we could most likely end up as Asia's worst economic performer of the year. China has begun to rebound and Vietnam is already growing. They're saying that Taiwan will be flat. South Korea's contraction might just be by 1.9%. The numbers that they've released are quite scary, saying that we could suffer a 13% decline for 5 years. What does the government need to do to arrest this forecast? Step by step.
Yeah, first and foremost, address the pandemic, right? So it's a health issue to begin with, okay? Which which has brought us to a confidence, lack of confidence.
Okay.
Okay. So syempre, takot ang consumer, takot ang worker, takot ang businessman to invest, no? So in this scenario, only the government can make the investment. And that's why I'm saying that the budget should be bigger.
Okay.
And that's why there's a need to extend Bayanihan 2, the JA, maybe even a Bayanihan 3. Mm-hmm. But I'd like to add, Karen, no? We also passed the CREATE bill.
Yes, I was going to move to that.
Yes, yeah. That also is a stimulus because we're reducing taxes to corporations, now big and small. You now have a two-tiered tax system for MSMEs. Your income 5 million and below, your tax is just 20%. That's a one-third reduction in tax rate.
Yeah. Okay?
Now, for big corporations, from 30 to 25%, okay, that's also a reduction. Now, for educational institutions and hospitals, we reduce our taxes for the next 3 years from 10% to 1% for the next 3 years. No? So there are many features under CREATE, which is good also.
Yeah.
Now, moving forward to attract investments, we made sure that the incentive package would be attractive enough. Of course, it could be better.
Yeah.
But it's much better than the original bill itself, which I think will assist us in attracting investment as well.
Okay.
So let's moving forward.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah. I don't mean to interrupt, but are you seeing when do you believe will we see the impact of CREATE? For example, Congressman Joey Salceda said he estimates, he gave numbers of $6 billion in foreign direct investments and 1 million people to be given jobs. And I've spoken with some cynics who say that doesn't seem to be the figure they're seeing just with CREATE alone. Are you projecting that?
I know, remember, they passed a different version.
Mm.
The Senate's bill is more attractive to begin with. Okay, but having said that, no, it all depends on what we do with the pandemic. I mean, yeah. If it will take us 3 to 5 years
yeah.
to inoculate our people, eh, di talagang ang bagal na recovery natin.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
Okay? If we are able to do it in 2 years,
mm-mm.
then I think the recovery will be by the second half of 2022.
Okay.
That in effect is the next administration.
Mm-mm.
And when I say recovery, that means you're back to pre-pandemic level.
Mm.
We will recover only the loss of 1,950,000,000,000, okay, in the second half of 2022.
Mm.
But that assumes you're able to roll out the vaccine in the next 2 years.
Mm.
So, kung 3 to 5 years yan, eh, yung recovery mo, 3 to 5 years din yan.
Mm.
So, it starts with that.
Mm. Okay. Okay.
All the others, like create, will be helpful for our recovery. But if we're unable to tame the virus, then all of that is useless.
Mm. Okay. Now, prior to the arrival of the vaccines, the best case scenario is March 2021. And that's best case, huh? The second possibility is second quarter of 2021. And some fear that may be too late because you have businesses wanting to already bounce back starting January. Prior to the arrival of the vaccine, what can government do in terms of policy or even tone to change the mood, the atmosphere, or the confidence level? I mean, I don't know the right words at this point, but I'm sure you get what I'm trying to say.
Yes. You know, confidence, okay. Saying that we will be able to vaccinate or inoculate our people in 3 to 5 years does not provide confidence. Saying that we can do it in 1 to 2 years will provide confidence. If you had in the budget, let's say, okay, this is our budget for vaccines next year, 150 billion, that will provide confidence. Mm-hmm. So maraming missed opportunity, sayang. Mm-hmm. Di ba? If we can show the public, hey, tignan nyo yung mga health worker natin, binabayaran natin lahat yan ng tama.
Mm-hmm.
That will provide confidence. Take a look, we're spending more now for our health infrastructure.
Mm-hmm.
We're building more capacity. That will provide. Pag nagkasakit kayo, sagot ng gobyerno.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it should be anyway. That's why PhilHealth has a reserve fund.
Mm.
Today, magkano nagastos ng PhilHealth sa COVID? Wala pang 10 billion.
Mm.
That should provide confidence. Mm. Oh, don't say 60 to 70% of the population. Say that all of you, we will vaccinate all of you. Walang pilitan.
Mm.
But if you want it, it's available for you.
Oo. I'm
that
curious.
That provide confidence. Yeah. One more thing, no, Karen?
Yeah,
no?
Go.
There are many countries who ordered vaccines more than their population.
Yeah.
We can talk to them. Pay them back. O yung sobra ninyo sa amin na. Ah? Like England. Oh.
Yeah.
They bought a lot of vaccines.
Mm.
Ah? Marami dyan, sobrang binili.
Yeah.
We can talk to them as well.
Mm-mm.
Ah? Maybe we can get a part of it.
Mm-mm.
Right?
No, that's a good point. So it's bilateral ties now that
yes,
matter.
Also.
Yeah, this
correct.
Is where it plays. So
okay.
I'm curious, was the bill filed by Senator Laila De Lima that every Filipino should be vaccinated for free? Was that necessary? Because Malacanang said that was superfluous. Does that help?
I think it always helps.
Mm.
It always helps. Of course, Laila's with the opposition, but I think it's good for her to say, or for anyone for that matter, sana all.
Mm-mm.
Right?
Mm-mm.
Nothing wrong with that. That provides confidence.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Okay. Last word, Senator Ralph. Actually, we discussed so much this morning, but anything you want to add before we go?
Oh, it will still take some time. There is light at the end of the tunnel. We now are watching globally the vaccine rollout. No?
Mm.
first in London, now in the US, in New York a few hours ago, so on and so forth. No? Okay. So clearly there is light at the end of the tunnel, but that tunnel is still long. Okay, so you still have to practice your social distancing, hand washing, don't let your wearing of masks, face shields, so on and so forth. At the same time, government should also do your contact tracing, man your quarantine facilities.
But clearly you want them to have a plan.
Correct.
That's one thing for sure.
Correct. Vaccine or no vaccine.
Okay, you want them to come up with a plan and tell the Senate about the plan.
To tell Congress so that we can appropriate the money necessary for it, right? Mm-hmm. And we can help them in explaining that to the public.
Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. Well, on that note, Senator Ralph Recto, as always, thank you so much for speaking with us this morning. We appreciate it. Thank you, sir.
Thank you for having me. Thank you, Karen.